Margaret Fountain. I represent our property located at 1601 Norman Drive, Spring Chase Apartments. We have some concerns as well as a question. We would like to know how far from the property line today the properties are located. We have some pictures that I brought with us. I've talked to Stafford Property in the past. Nothing has been done as far as the upkeep of the property. That was something when they located there that they agreed with Spring Chase Apartments that they would do. And since pictures speak a little bit louder than words, I'll let you have those. We're concerned, of course, about the noise level and the lights there. When you go in there at nighttime, and I walked in there and checked at nighttime, there's absolutely no lighting whatsoever except on the very front of Norman Drive. Even the lights in the back of the buildings are not working or they're burned out. The fence is in really bad disrepair. It's open to the property. There's a lot of garbage thrown back there. It presents a dangerous atmosphere as far as our residents are concerned. We're very concerned about that matter. We're concerned about the lighting coming over on the residents. You know, if you were in an apartment, you certainly wouldn't want to hear the type of noise that would produce inside your unit as well as being outside the unit. So we would ask that, you know, that be addressed, you know, if the car wash comes there. The landscaping is very poorly done in there. You have your fire signs that are, you know, for your fire lanes. Some of them are faded totally out, and some of them are hidden in the rough and the shrubbery, and it's not kept up as well. So we ask that, you know, that you consider these things if you put the car wash in there, because it can take away from our revenue. And it also represents the city of Valdosta as we do. And we try to keep our community in good repair and keep it nice looking for the city and represent it and represent ourselves that way. So we feel like that this could affect our revenue, you know, as well as, you know, the potential to have new residents in there that want to stay within the community. So we ask that you do look at the pictures and that you do consider what we're asking.
Okay, are there any questions for this speaker from the commissioners?
I have one.
Ms. McLean?
Ma'am, is here. I hear what you're saying. If those things were addressed, would you still have an objection?
If they were addressed and they were kept up properly, you know, and the noise level and the lighting were addressed and not, you know, you say until 10 o'clock at night. You know, at 10 o'clock at night, you know, that's pretty late as far as most of the residents are concerned. You know, the type of residents, the demographics that we have in there are working, you know, people, middle class. We have a lot of Air Force people in there that, you know, get up real early in the morning, you know, so if the noise is loud, 10 o'clock's pretty late. And it just depends on that type of noise, you know. If it's addressed and they keep it up, which as you can see from the pictures, you know, the past hasn't been an experience that, you know, that we would believe it, that they would do, but we would certainly consider that.
Okay. Any other questions?
Mr. Chairman, I have a question.
Mr. Wiles?
I'm just wondering, is Stafford Property the current owner of this property, or are they responsible for the condition that these pictures show?
That is what was agreed on when they first moved in there, and that was a contractual agreement when they first moved in there, as far as I know, that they keep that fence line up. The fence actually belongs to them.
It's very hard to enforce, so.
We called them in the past and got no results whatsoever.
Yes, sir, could you state your name and address for the record, please?
Yeah, I'm Houston Brown. I live at 227 West Moore Street, Valdosta, Georgia, 0602. I think the main things we're concerned about is the fence line and them, correct me if I'm wrong, but that the fence is completely deteriorated. It needs to be replaced, and then the lighting and the noise is our main three issues. That would affect our property.
All right, do we have any other questions?
Can I ask a question?
Sure. Just stand.
Exactly. Respond. When researching this, or maybe you didn't look, did you find anything that they were supposed to keep up the property or anything?
We are not aware of any agreements between Stafford and Spread Chase Apartments. And the subject property is a portion of the shopping center along Warner Drive. That's the area that we focus on. It's distant from the apartments. We do not examine the shopping center. Okay. But I've made a note of it, and we will get the city marshals out there for sure.
Another question. If this is approved, will that be additional buffers with the new specifications we've got now on the building? Whatever's there is there.
Yeah. Right. The new development does not directly abut Spring Chase. There's a distance in between.
Okay.
If it did directly abut, there would be other development issues. And also, staff would have a little different opinion in terms of appropriateness and site layout and so forth.
Okay. That's all.
Okay. Any other questions?
I have a question for you.
Okay, go ahead.
How was the daily hours of operation at the time?
It was meant to be broadly in reference to the applicant during the day, not the middle of the night.
Mm-hmm.
Some car wash facilities can operate 24 hours a day if they like self-serve. We did not want that. We did not feel that it was appropriate. The applicant had indicated 8 to 8,
mm-hmm.
and so this is outside of that. You can recommend more restrictive hours, certainly, as a condition, which if the departments have a concern about that, that may be a good idea.
Did I ask any questions? Matt? Mark?
Sir? No, we don't need to address them unless they have a question or something. So, appreciate it. Okay, any other questions? Okay, thank you.